Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss some results on selling price and cost price. First of all, we suppose that the profit percent be equal to R percent. We know that profit is equal to the selling price, that is SP, minus the cost price, which is CP. So from here we have the selling price SP is equal to the profit plus, let this be equation 1. Now we have profit percent is equal to profit upon the cost per CP, and this whole multiplied by 100. This gives us profit is equal to the profit percent into the cost per CP, and this whole upon 100. Or you can say the profit is equal to R upon 100, since profit percent is R percent, so R upon 100 into the cost price CP. Let this be equation 2. Now from equations 1 and 2 we get the selling price SP is equal to R upon 100 multiplied by the cost price CP, and this whole plus the cost price CP. That is, we have substituted the value of this profit in equation 1. Further, we get the selling price SP is equal to 1 plus R upon 100, and this whole multiplied by the cost price CP. Or the selling price SP is equal to 100 plus R upon 100, and this whole multiplied by the cost price CP. Let this be result A. Now this formula could be used to find out the selling price of an article when given the cost price and the profit percent. And here we have taken this R to be the profit percent. Now, from this formula, we have the cost price CP is equal to the selling price SP multiplied by 100, and this whole upon 100 plus R, that is the profit percent. Let this be result B. Now, this formula could be used to find out the cost price of an article when given the selling price and the profit percent. That is, we have this R here is the profit percent. Now, suppose loss percent be equal to R percent. Now, we know that loss is equal to the cost price CP minus the selling price SP. And from here we have the selling price SP is equal to the cost price minus loss. Let this be equation 3. We also know that loss percent is equal to loss upon the cost price CP, and this whole multiplied by 100. From here we get loss is equal to the cost price CP into loss percent, and this whole upon 100. Now we have taken loss percent as R percent. So we now have loss is equal to the cost price CP into R upon 100. Let this be result 4. So, from equations 3 and 4, that is, we substitute the value of this loss in equation 3. So we get the selling price SP is equal to the cost price minus loss, that is cost price into R, which is the loss percent upon 100. Or you can say the selling price SP is equal to 1 minus R upon 100, and this whole multiplied by the cost price. So further we get the selling price SP is equal to 100 minus R upon 100, and this whole multiplied by the cost price CP. Let this be result C. So this formula could be used to find out the selling price when the cost price and the loss percent are given to us. That is, here we have R as the loss percent. Now from this formula only we can derive that the cost price CP is equal to the selling price SP multiplied by 100, this whole upon 100 minus R, which is the loss percent. Let this be result D. This formula could be used to find out the cost price of an article given the selling price and the loss percent, where this R is the loss percent. Let us consider an example. If the selling price SP of a television set be given as $500 and the profit percent be equal to 25%, then we need to find the cost price of the television set. As the selling price and the profit percent are given to us, so we can use this result B to find out the cost price of the article. So we have the cost price, that is CP, is equal to selling price SP into 100 upon 100 plus the profit percent R. So we have CP is equal to 500 into 100 upon 100 plus 25. That is, further we have 500 into 100 upon 125. Now 125, 4 times is 500, so we have the cost price of the television set is equal to $400. We can also solve this question, that is, we can also find the cost price of the television set using another method, that is the unitary method, in which we suppose that the cost price of the television set be $100. We are given the selling price of the television set as $500, and we also have the profit percent as 25%. So this means if the selling price is 100 plus 25, that is $125, then the cost price is $100. So if the selling price is $1, then the cost price is 100 upon $125. So this means if the selling price is $500, then the cost price is equal to 100 upon 125 into 500. 125 4 times is 500, so this is equal to $400. Thus, the cost price of the television set is $400. So this is another method to find out either the cost price or the selling price of an article given the profit or the loss percent. This completes the session. Hope you have understood the results on selling price and the cost price.